Yeah, so finally we've got some information about the compartment examination. Whether compartment exams will occur or not in the present circumstances, it is difficult to conduct. The dates have not been announced, but the CBSE has given a letter stating that the compartment will be held soon. Okay, so I'm here to give some clarifications regarding this letter because still there is a confusion how to go about it. So this video is to help class 10 and 12 students who are appearing for the compartment exams or want to improve upon their scores. And there were some students who missed their exams due to the riots in Delhi, and there are other parts of India due to various reasons. So the letter has been issued yesterday, and it has been uploaded and reached most of the schools today. So a clarification on the subject is that how to go about this now, how to give the compartment exams. Now, the proposal is that the exams will be conducted in the month of September. Okay, the dates have not yet been announced, but it is going to be conducted in September 2020. The date we are expecting sometime next week. Okay, by I think between 18th and 24th approximately, we'll get the exact dates of which exam is going to be held. Now, there's a major change in the format of the compartment. Earlier, the compartment exams, the student had to apply online on the link and give the exam. But this time, the regular candidates have to appear from their schools. The regular candidates, I repeat, all the regular candidates have to apply through their schools, and the private candidates will only apply directly through the CBSE website. So the regular candidates need to contact their school, and there is a link that is given there. They'll have to go through that link. The schools will have to take the onus of filing that with information of their compartmental students. So the schools have to submit the LOC for the compartmental examination, just like we do. The schools are going to do for the normal candidates, as in the, so they fill the form and, you know, they register the candidates. So the same process has to be done for the compartment students. And there is a site given here through e-pariksha link. Okay, this is the e-pariksha link. You'll have to click on this. And this site is active already. And those names who are submitted through this online process only will be allowed to give the exam in September. No other way of giving the compartment exam. So make sure that you follow up with your school authorities and register on this site. That is the e-pariksha link for both class 10 and class 12. Now, who are the people eligible to give the compartment exams? Okay, so this year is very special. So we have many categories of people who want to give this compartmental exams. The first candidate of the first category of students is the candidates who appeared in the month of February, March, those, and whose result has been declared as compartment. Okay, so in their report, the compartment word aaya hai. So they need to give this compartment in order to be declared as passed. Okay, so if you have clear pass and there is compartment and there is fail. Okay, so if you have the word compartment written in your report card, then you are eligible to give the compartment. That means the compartment could be in the one subject or two subjects. You'll have to see which subject is given compartment in that, right? So if you've got below 33, that is a compartment. Then the candidates of class 12 who had appeared for improvement of performance as a regular candidate in the subjects for which examination was scheduled from 1st July to 15th July. Okay, now class 12 students have this option of giving improvement. Okay, so if they're not satisfied, they need to apply for the improvement. And if you feel that your marks were low and you wanted to increase your marks, that was scheduled to be held between 1st and 15th July. That was postponed due to the COVID conditions prevailing all across the country. So now they are saying that even those candidates can give the compartment exams and improve on their existing scores. But please remember, this facility is only given to class 12 students. Class 10 students cannot appear for an exam if they are passed. They can give only if it is compartmental. So class 12 students, if they had applied earlier for improvement, then they will be given this chance to give this exam, right? So this is the second category. They had applied for improvement of performance as a regular candidate, and the result has been declared as NC in the subject concerned. Okay, so that's not final. So they are eligible for improvement. The third category is candidates of class 12 who have appeared as regular candidates in six subjects. Okay, now in class 12, I have explained in another video also that you can take 6 subjects, out of which 5, if you are passing in 5, that means you are technically passed. So 6 subject, even if you fail, there is no problem because you are declared pass. But now these students who have failed in that 6th subject, if suppose your 6th subject, you have passed in 5 and suppose maths you had failed. Now this is a chance to take stock of the situation. In case you feel that those 5 subjects you have passed is okay, then fine, no need to give. But suppose you, the 6th subject in which you have failed and you want to pass that subject, okay, whether it's maths or physical or whichever subject you want, and you want to give that. So this is the time that you can give that examination, and if you, and you are eligible to give the compartment. So same for class 12 category. Again, this is for class 12 category, those who have taken 6 subjects and they have been declared pass. But if they want to clear the 6th subject, they can give that examination. And the 4th category, okay, that is a little tricky. That is the candidates of class 10 and 12 who have been punished under the category of UFM. Okay, they were punished. Now, why were they punished? Because they were using unfair means. You know that the rule says that if you carry some books or chits or you, some writing material is found on you, or you are looking into somebody's and the examiner, the evaluator is, you know, complaining to CBSE that this student has used unfair means. So this student is placed under the category of UFM. So that is this UFM. Okay, that means the child has been caught using unfair means. So this is an opportunity. Earlier, the punishment was so severe that the child was barred from giving examination. So that now they are giving this opportunity to even those students that if you are punished under the UFM category, the current examinations, then you can give that examination in the compartment. Okay. So wherein their current examination has been cancelled. So obviously, when you are caught cheating, so that is null, that those marks are not declared technically. The, even if you scored some marks, the it's null and void, it's not declared. So that those type of students also will be given the chance to give the examination for the compartment. Okay, so schools have been informed already about, the schools will be, have already got this letter, and they'll be informed about the date for downloading the admit cards later on. Okay, so the admit cards have to be collected from the school, the regular candidates. And in case of any discrepancy, the school should contact the concerned regional office of the board. So the first contact is your school, and if there is any problem with the your admit card or any other problems, then the school will contact the regional office. Okay. Now, a separate circular is already issued for private candidates. That is also available in the website. So the private candidates, obviously, they are not affiliated to any school, so they can directly go to the link and apply the for the compartment. Okay, so if you are aware of private candidates, you can tell those students that you can directly apply online on the CBSE's website, and the schedule will remain same for the private candidates as well as the regular candidates. There is no difference. So the dates will be declared and those dates will be same. Okay. But the private candidates will be giving the exam directly from this link. They will be registering for this, but those who are regular candidates, they will be contacting the school and they will be filling the link through the schools. So those who have appeared in March 2019, okay, there were some candidates or students who appeared last year and they have still not cleared. Okay, so March they give the exam, they did not clear. Then they give a compartment in July, they did not clear. And then again, second chance. So your first chance was the normal exam, which they gave in 2019. The first compartment was held. Then the second chance was given now. And all those candidates, now they didn't pass all the 3 times. Okay, they didn't pass in 2019. They didn't pass in the compartment. They didn't pass in 2020, that is this year. Now this is going to be another chance for them to apply as private candidates and give the exam. So even if those students were affiliated to some school, they were studying in some school, they cannot apply as a regular candidate now. This third chance that is being given, they have to be applying as private candidates only. They cannot apply as regular candidates. So in your school, if you have a case who failed last year and still has not cleared, please advise the student that the student has to apply as a private candidate. School will not take responsibility for that. The child can directly apply on the website. Okay, so that's about the private candidates and those regular candidates. So candidates of 12 who had applied for improvement of performance as private candidates. Okay, now what was happening was that, you know, there were some candidates who gave the application for improvement of performance that could not be held. So that examination is also scheduled in September. The exact dates will be made known soon. So this is about the class 10 and 12, about the private candidates and regular candidates. There were some candidates in class 10 who had applied for additional subjects. Okay, this is, we are talking about additional subject in class 10, that is subjects like computer applications, code 165, and informatics and communication technology, that is 166. This was supposed to be held on 20th March. Okay, but we know that, you know, because of the lockdown, this examination was not held. The five major subjects of class 10 were held. Again, this exam was not held. So all these students who want to give this exam, 165 code and 166 code, they are eligible to give the exam if they wish during the compartmental. Okay, so that is another. And of course, as I told you, that anybody's exam got cancelled due to the riots in Delhi or any other reasons, they were sick due to medical reasons, they were not able to reach the center, you know, n number of reasons are there, and they couldn't appear for a particular exams, all these students are also eligible to give the compartmental examination, but they have to apply this on time. Okay, so the consolidated mark sheet will not be issued to the candidates whose result are already passed. Okay, the consolidated mark sheet will not be given to the candidates who's already passed. Okay, so if you're already passing, this is not going to be given to you right now. And after the improvement is over, then those marks are going to be finalized and given. If it is private or regular or whatever category, UFM category, whatever, it will be declared by the board on the website subsequently. So having known this, there will be no extension of dates. So we have to be very careful about the dates. Okay, so I've told you who are the people who are eligible for this exam and who are for class 10 and 12. So it's all on the website there. Now let me come to the fee and schedule, which is very important. The time is very, very less. So the fee to be remitted per student, if you are residing in India, if you are in any part of India, then the cost per subject is 300 rupees. And if you are studying in a school outside India, then it's 2000 rupees. And the schedule is given as 13th August to 20th August. They are very strict on this, up to 5 p.m. The moment they cross 5 p.m., then your application will not be accepted. So please remember to apply for the compartmental between 13th August and 20th August. Okay, so that is 13th August today and to the next Thursday, 5 p.m. And with late fee, that is, you have to pay the 300 rupees or the 2000 as the case may be, plus the late fee of 2000 rupees, they will accept 21st August to 22nd August, again up to 5 p.m. After that, they are not going to accept anything, right? So no extensions will be allowed. Then all this late fee and everything that is calculated, this is all obviously refundable. Once you give the fees and it's your duty to reach for the compartmental exam. If you don't give, then obviously this is not going to be refunded. Okay. The students' details should be entered on the website before 20th August. It's very important that the last date is respected in this case, and everything should be finalized and the fee also should be paid, right? After 20th August, no sort of application entertainment will be done by any regional offices or schools. Nothing can be done for this. Okay, they have exempted one category of students from paying the fees. That is, those students of class 12 whose exams were scheduled between 1 and 15. They had applied for improvement and the exam could not be held. So that category of students are exempted from paying late fee. So all the other categories, the fee is applicable as prescribed in the form. procedure for submitting online submission by the schools. First, a general list of candidates placed in the compartmental from the school login. So when the school logins to the portal, they will automatically get a list of students who have failed or those who are in compartment. What you need to do is select the roll number and subject of the candidates who want to appear for the compartment. So you will select your roll number, okay, and the candidate's name, and you will upload that, and then an application ID will be generated, and the payment can be made on the spot. You can enter the roll number of the candidates, and the details will be auto-generated. Okay, details will be auto-generated because you've already applied earlier, so your details are already there with CBSE. So many of the things, when as soon as you enter some of the data, they will auto-fill it, and you just need to submit it. So the final list will be generated, and this will be kept as a record in the school, right? And all digital payments are accepted: debit card, credit cards, NEFT, RTGS. All this will be accepted. Okay. So before the payment of fee, schools can take a print of LOC in the form of checklist. And once the fee is paid, the final LOC will be printed and no correction can be made in the online or offline mode. So it's very important that you fill in very correct names, your correct roll number, because once the form is submitted, corrections are not possible. Okay. And if your school is in outside India, it may take 2-3 days to, you know, complete the process, because the financial transaction takes a little bit of time. So that takes a little bit of time. But if you're in India, you will get the auto-generated slip of confirmation within 24 hours or maybe less than that, very soon. Almost instantly, you get it. Okay. So that's it. I hope I was clear. So compartmental exam, just to wind up the whole thing, the compartmental exams are going to take place in September. The dates will be announced soon. So you need to hurry up. The last date is 20th August. So 13th August to 20th August, you need to contact your schools. If you are a private candidate, then you need to apply directly to the website and get these formalities done, right? So if you still want to follow up, then obviously you have the site, CBSE site, that is www.cbse.nic.in. You can always visit the website and follow what is the latest CBSE news. Thank you so much.